2K Sports. We've got
hello,
basketball.
Everybody.
I'm Damon Burks.
Yes, it is.
The young NBA season.
We are to another association elimination
it's
game.
Dominique Wilkins and the Atlanta Hawks going up against the Los Angeles Lakers. I'll be back at halftime.
As it's the Hawks and the Lakers. Magic Johnson, Dominique Wilkins. Showing highlights of Kobe there.
Players getting themselves into game mode with the tip-off just moments away.
Magic Johnson.
Welcome, everyone, to this 2K Sports broadcast live in Los Angeles at the Staples Center. Last outing for Atlanta, they won that game against the Thunder in Oklahoma City.
And there's the lineup.
And a lot of their points didn't come from the usual suspects in that win, Clark.
You're exactly right, Steve. The guys coming off the bench played a huge role.
Carney and
looking at the starting five for the Kobe. Hawks. Devin Harris is out there with Lou Williams. And then it's Ivan Johnson. And there's Dominique Wilkins. And it's Horford at the center position. And for the Lakers, Bryant is out there with Kobe. Then there's Rodney Carney. Then it's Hill. And it's Johnson in at the point.
You know, not a lot of people knew what to make of the Lakers last season. I mean, first year with Mike Brown as the head coach, an aging group, a maturing group, if you will. But they showed they still have that Laker magic at times.
Or for the pass to Harris, Johnson outside. Rebounded by the Lakers. This game coming after a loss against the Jazz.
And Kevin, when you don't take advantage of your trips to the free throw line, which they definitely did not, it's tough.
When it was a surprise to figure out that they would lose to the Jazz during that game, but both teams played great.
After the Lakers, they struggled at times, but by the end of the season, Steve, they looked just as good as any team in contention for the title.
Well, you knew that, you know, it was going to take some time with the new coach as they put everything together. But defensively, that
this is a good Lakers team.
Offensively, they have their growing pains. But by the end of the year, I thought they kicked it into gear pretty well.
Carney kicks to Bryant. It's stolen by Johnson. Pushes to Horford. Back to Williams. Kicks to Johnson. Outside Williams. Jacks up a three. Hits the bucket. Williams has got himself on the board with
Luis Williams.
And here's Los Angeles. It's a three-point game. And this game, the first chance they've had to see Atlanta.
Well, they were the better team when these two teams got together a year ago. No question. Sweeping the season series 2-0.
Kobe.
Kobe again.
Nice move from the player. We basically come to expect nothing less from.
Harris with him. He picked up 15 points in their last win against Oklahoma City.
And what stood out to me in particular was the gorgeous playmaking out there. He was finding his teammates in great positions.
Good defense by L.A.
Wilkins picks him up. Kobe dishes to Johnson. Over Harris. They get a pass. And Hill.
Rough and rugged down there in the low post.
That's his trademark. Hard rebounds. Hard finishes. Up high and down hard.
And he never stops working. That's what I really appreciate about him, guys.
Harris kicks to Williams.
Luis Williams left wide open.
6 points for Williams. It makes you wonder how the standings might look if some of these teams, you know, actually changed conferences.
Well, Kevin, I think it'd be a whole new world, a totally different world, a whole new set of matchups. But at least everybody gets a couple of games a year to check everybody else.
Kobe!
And it's 6 points for Kobe Bryant.
This has been the start that they had hoped for, coming out knocking down four of their first five shots.
And here is Harris from the arc.
And there's Williams. That's good on the assist by Aaron. Williams has got nine.
And head coach Mike Brown, a very defensive-minded guy, worked as an assistant in San Antonio for years under Greg Popovich. And last year, his first with the Lakers, they were much improved defensively.
Lobs it up there. Hill, no good.
That would have been a nice alley-oop there.
Oh, you got to love the effort, though. Almost showtime.
Harris passes to Horford and Johnson with the block. And they're able to recover. Second shot opportunity, and that one's good.
What a take.
Not much defense, though.
Lakers trailed by five. Can you talk about the defensive first philosophy for Coach Mike Brown? And Steve, it certainly helps to have the size the Lakers do inside to use that kind of system, to use that philosophy.
That's right, Kevin. And remember, they had the same philosophy in San Antonio when Mike Brown was an assistant because of the size with Duncan and Robinson. So with the Lakers' size now, it's a similar defensive scheme, forcing everything to the baseline, into the help, make players shoot over the top of the Laker bigs. And it's been a blueprint for success for Mike Brown, not only in L.A., but Cleveland, Indiana, and San Antonio as well.
Here's Bryant. That's good.
Trademark.
The Hawks leading by five. Williams kicks to Horford. And he races to the bucket for two. Horford's got his second bucket.
Atlanta with a good pace right now.
At the offensive end. A nice start, no question, making all the right moves here early.
Carney dishes to Johnson. Battles through Trevor and Johnson's got his first basket of the night. Hawks have gone 7 of 11 from the field to begin the game. Goes up on the wing.
Luis Williams again.
I think he's setting tone for the entire team in this quarter. Tremendous stuff. Good action.
Well, you look back to the offseason, and one of the quiet moves.
Whoa, Kobe with a quick shot.
Signing as a free agent with the Atlanta Hawks. You know, he was so good with the 76ers. Really was the guy down the stretch who would take the big shots for him. So he's a little bit surprised that Philadelphia let him go. But he'll be a good fit in Atlanta, replacing Joe Johnson.
It's Wilkins with the drive. Good on the shot. Wilkins has got his third basket of the night.
That's an old-fashioned finish there, guys. Going to the finger roll to get the easy two.
Johnson, the pass to Bryant. In low to Hill. And that one's good.
Jordan. Williams, man, you don't have to come in off the bench and be that combo guard guy anymore. They'll use him right from the tip, and he can just concentrate on scoring the basketball, which he does well.
Luis Williams with the ball again. Dominic Wilkins.
Again, they attacked the hoop from the lane, and it's been really good to them.
A good possession with all that pressure over them.
Four of their last five buckets coming in the paint area.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Another year in the playoff for the Hawks, but also another year of coming up short for them. They took the Celtics to six games, but couldn't get
Looks like this Atlanta team's still pumped up.
Lakers trail by nine. Johnson outside. The feed to Carney. Right side, Kobe. Shot over Wilkins. Shots blocked by Kobe. Kobe's got 8 points. Back to the Hawks and Celtics. Just a great matchup in the first round. But the Hawks fans had been hoping for a little bit more, Steve, and it didn't come to fruition.
Well, this is a franchise that historically has just not been able to get over the hump. They've been good, but not great. I mean, they're kind of stuck in that space right now. You know, can they make that next step? We'll see.
Luis Williams again answers.
That chemistry has helped them jump out to this big first quarter lead. A cohesive team can beat a talented one almost every time.
We might be seeing that today.
Fires from deep. Williams kicks to Johnson. Wilkins. Back to Johnson.
Oh.
and he throws it down.
And he brings the lights out.
Roof down with that one.
Yeah, and really a dunk contest dunk that time. Wow.
Yeah, unreal. What a dunk.
Lakers trail by 9. Johnson dishes to Bryant. Carney. Pass to Kobe. Over Wilkins. And Kobe Bryant. Kobe's got 10 points in the game.
He's really come out this quarter saying, give me the ball. I'm taking over. I'm demanding the ball. And you know what? He's delivered a tremendous performance this quarter.
Williams with the ball. Picked up by Bryant. Johnson, even with work on the board, pays off with the second chance points.
Excellent job carving out space under the glass to make that putback possible.
Johnson, the pass to Bryant. Carney kicks to Johnson. He feeds it to Carney. From outside the arc. Excellent D there from Williams.
Some impressive chemistry we're seeing from these legends on the Lakers team. They are in their errors. Not to say it like it's that far, but you know what I mean?
Derek Fisher is the president of the NBA Players Union as well. So obviously Horford, a lot of brains to go along with that brawn.
I don't know if any of the legends have played on each team together.
As a leader for this team, you know, talk about that.
That's on this Lakers team.
Well, I like a lot about it. He's skilled, he's tough, he's physical, he's consistent.
If anybody does know, they can drop a comment.
Also, as a guy who will do the little things, the hustle plays and the dirty work, and he sets a great example for the rest of his teammates.
He sinks the second.
Yeah, he's a physical, hard-working big man, kind of an old-school power forward. Great IQ for the game. You know, he may not be the most explosive player in the league, but he's got a lot of substance. This guy's a winner.
And that work ethic and character of his extends to rebounding as well. I mean, he's extremely aggressive in pursuit of the ball. He'll get his share of second-chance buckets offensively for sure.
Meeks passes to Nitch. Puts up a three. Gets it to go.
Steve Nash comes in and makes the bucket.
Yeah, they look like they were raring to go in this one. A lot of offense early on.
And Davis, here we go.
Atlanta going with the Birdman again.
This has been a strong statement by them.
Baron Davis.
The glass early. Yeah, I agree, Clark. I love the physical play, the fact that they're taking the game.
Doc
right
Rivers. Austin Rivers, I believe,
Jameson up on top. Meeks
will be in.
By Davis. And Meeks kicks to world peace. The Hawks leading by 7.
You feel good for Larry Drew, who's in his third
Baron
season
Davis.
As a head coach, because he's been 18 years as an assistant before he finally got his big break with the Hawks. In all, he's been with Atlanta since 2004, so he knows these players well.
Nash kicks to Meeks. Gay outside.
Rudy in.
Shots good by Gay. Atlanta's got a perfect 4-4 from beyond the arc. All the points coming by way of the 3 in the first quarter. And Larry Drew, well liked by the players in his time.
Bellinelli
probably made it a little bit easier for the ownership to make him the head coach as he replaces Mike Woodson.
Well, it's always easier to be the good cop, you know, when you're the assistant coach. All of a sudden, you become the head coach, and you need to be tougher. You need to discipline players a little bit. It can be harder to have those relationships.
They get the defense on Nash.
Fine balance, but Drew has done a nice job of establishing himself with this Hawks team.
They retain possession. Horford could.
And I'll tell you what, they've been a step slow here early on.
I agree with you. I mean, they're allowing too many open shots. They seem a little sluggish to me. Nash kicks to Gay. He dishes it to Meeks. Launches it. Atlanta with the rebound. 106 left in the first quarter of the game.
Here's Rivers. Again, the Hawks score.
A lot of points for them here.
Doc early Rivers.
In the first quarter. I mean, this could get ugly. Yeah, they sure could.
We'll see how this goes.
Judging by their lead, this game could get out of hand in a hurry. Here's Jameson, a pitcher. Jameson's got his first points of the game. The Hawks leading by 12. Here's Rivers, the dish to Bellinelli. How's it go with a three? Another three for Atlanta.
The defense has done.
And they're working on their victory streak right now. They could be at three-peat.
Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
For victories.
And here's Atlanta.
In this beginning of the season.
Fishes it down.
They built an early lead here, really pushing ahead.
Well, they've got a huge advantage, points in the paint, Steve, and they're attacking early, so taking advantage of scoring in close. Nash gets the world peace. Anderson with the block. Now Rivers. Davis with it. Picked up by world peace. 3 seconds left. That's good. Ellinelli's got 8 points.
And he breaks it in 2.5.
And as we conclude the first quarter, a one-sided game so far. Hawks ahead, up 19. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports.
The Hawks already with a lead, already in this first quarter. Coming in off of two games of a win.
The Dallas Mavericks take on Chris Bosh and the Miami Heat. Catch the action next Sunday night.
We'll see how the Heat will be doing during that time.
Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And a very convincing performance here from the Hawks so far.
And they've done a nice job here offensively to establish a rhythm and a pace to this game.
And I like that they're finding ways to score, playing well here, Steve. You got it!
And so in the game for the Hawks, we've got Dominique Wilkins. Teague out there with Rivers. And it's Ivan Johnson. And it's Anderson.
Defense that time didn't do quite enough. I mean, it takes a lot of effort to stop him when he gets in tight. You know, the Lakers have long been the pride of the West for the better part of the century, but every so often they can hit tough stretches, and last year they had a hard time with Moose.
And LU jam.
I don't think it's possible to make
and a we're seeing some chemistry out there today.
So well, Clark, too. Not too shabby on that jam.
Not bad at all. And it takes perfect timing to pull off that alley-oop, but these two guys seem to have that synergy between each other.
Blake with it. Picked up by Rivers. Barnes dishes to Blake. Backs down. Jameson feeds to Blake. Inside. Wants to get it to Jameson and does. That's good. Jameson's got a second bucket tonight. Yeah, they just couldn't do what the rest of the Western Conference playoff teams did against the East, and the Lakers, Steve, were 9 up and 9 down, right at 500.
That kind of surprising, given that the East was the weaker conference, for sure. I would have expected a better record from the Lakers. They really got off to a slow start, particularly on the road, and I think that cost them a little bit at the end.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Brooke.
Well, for Rudy Gay last season, returned to playing injury sidelined him the season prior. He said of the injury, "I spent a whole lot of time just being mad and depressed. And then it came to me, a way I can be effective is to learn as much as I can and add that to my game." He said, "Now I take care of my body better. I'm more polished." He even said, "I think I'm a better person." Guys?
Well, adversity can sometimes bring out the best in people. Gay is certainly playing at a high level. Blake up top, defended by Wilkins. The 10-footer.
Whoa, huge rejection.
Here's Rivers. He passes to Teague. Blake with a steal. He kicks to Nash. Dishes to Barnes. Over Wilkins. And that one's good, Barnes. Barnes has got his first 2 points of the night.
Points in the paint have been the main course, or main entree, if you will. They just keep pounding it inside.
Now they're seeing no resistance defensively in the paint area, so the defense has got to be tougher.
And Antoine Jameson is a player who can help any team in the league with his scoring. And as he gets later in his career,
wait for them to bring it down to double digits on the low end.
Wilkins with a screen on Nash. Johnson, the pass to T, and stolen by Nash. Barnes kicks to Nash. Again, the Lakers. He's been on winning teams and some losing teams, but never wanted to complain either way.
For all of his special physical gifts and what he does on the basketball court, which is otherworldly, quite honestly, the thing that I've marveled at is his demeanor and disposition and how he's handled the bright lights of stardom and fame and expectations and pressure. Really, since he was 15 or 16 years old, this guy has always carried himself much older than he is, and nobody's perfect, so we all stub our toes here and there, but I don't know anybody that could have handled what he's handled any better than he has over the course of his NBA career.
Here's Rivers. Gets it to go. And the Hawks lead by 10.
Something has to change, guys. That's 10 straight points coming in the paint against this team.
Well, they got to collapse in there, and everybody's got to be conscious of it. It's a team effort in protecting the paint.
Come on.
Control the ball, and everybody's got to get in there and keep the defense locked down.
And the Lakers call time here.
He's one of those teams, guys, that's just good enough to be in the playoffs year after year, but not really great enough to contend for a championship. And it's a tough spot to be in the NBA. But if you don't have a superstar player, which Atlanta doesn't, it's just tough to get over the hump.
A platoon swap here for the Lakers. Here's Kobe. 10 points for him. And the Lakers with another miss.
I thought he'd make that one. That's his range, and the defense nowhere to be seen.
Quick shot on the possession. I'm loving he's having his comfortability out there. He's taking shots.
Perhaps consider trying, you know, Steve and Clark to make a move for a superstar player or get over the hump, or, you know. How do you think it's going to play out, Clark?
Kobe is playing.
When you're trying to put the puzzle pieces together, you always have to consider making a move for an elite-level talent. But when you look at the Hawks, they've got enough good and great players that if they can keep them in Atlanta, one of those guys might blossom into that elite star and be able to take Atlanta to the next level, perhaps even to the final.
That one goes. Count it. Lakers trail by 13. Johnson outside, kicks it to Kobe. Davis is up. Fades back. Kobe Bryant. Kobe's got four this quarter.
I think he's done his part to try to keep him in this game. It's been a solid effort from him, guys.
Rivers with it, and it's Johnson picking him up. They set the screen. Elbow shot. In Atlanta again with the bucket.
Austin Rivers.
Lakers shooting a superb 63% from the field. On the wing, Kobe. Open look. And Horford pulls it down. Horford's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. And there's the pass.
They're at the same time testing Kobe's shooting.
Los Angeles has gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. The feed now to Kobe. Over Davis. And again.
Yeah, they're thinking they have a defensive plan, but that shot just went in.
To make shots while being heavily guarded. And I don't know how he does it, but he figures out a way to get the ball in the basket, even under pressure.
That's exactly right, Steve. But also, he's a tremendous finisher. I mean, it doesn't matter if he draws contact on his way to the rim or not. He'll find a way to get it to go.
Darren Davis is now
trail by 16. Johnson dishes to Bryant. Game.
over Bellinelli. Offensive rebound. Kicks it out to Gay. Over Davis. And Kobe the bucket will be a two-time Rudy Gay.
Yeah, I had a feeling he was going to make that next shot again.
The Hawks leading by 14.
We'll see if Baron Davis answers back. Both exceptional players.
Pass to Horford. Second chance effort. And yes, sir, that one drops. Horford's got 11.
Well, they've built a big lead here so far, and a lot of it has to do with how well they've been rebounding.
Yeah, every time they make a stop, they're securing the rebound. And that's really allowed them. In from that mid-range area.
Seems like every hoop they get, Steve, is a step or two in from the three-point line. I mean, you got to take what the other team is giving you, and they're certainly doing that.
And there's Baron Davis answering.
He took advantage of that pick, and he did the rest, knocking down the J.
Timeout call for Lakers.
And for Baron Davis, a herniated disc in his lower back had him contemplating retirement.
Him and Bellinelli rooting for each other right now tonight, making points, making points.
After missing the early part of the year, he pretty well for New York.
A platoon swap here for the Lakers, and the Hawks will go for a different look here. Ivan Johnson, he's checked in for Anderson. Stevenson comes in for Marco Bellinelli. Lou Williams has checked in for Baron Davis. And it's Rivers in for Rivers. Here's Hill. He trains the two-point jump shot. Hill's got 8 points here in this quarter. And Baron Davis, in his prime, when he was physically right, he was one of the most physically dominant point guards in the NBA. The problem, Clark, is he just can't stay healthy.
Well, those days are behind him. He was strong and explosive and had an advantage in those areas against other guards. But his game is now more close to the ground, and that allows his ball handling and vision skills to still make him effective.
And Antoine Jameson's bucket on the 2 by 8. 6 points for Jameson. The Hawks leading by 12. Rivers with it. Guarded now by Nash. He feeds it to Stevenson. Lets it go from deep. Good.
Way too much time and space on that three. He'll make that one all the time.
Well, it's a warm-up jumper, Steve. The kind that you can knock down still to this day. And you're one of the best all-time three-pointers we've had in the NBA. But you got to at least try to challenge it.
The Hawks shooting has been just uncontainable. 72%. Johnson kicks to Rivers. He dishes it to Williams. Dish out to Stevenson. Pass to Horford. Feeds it to Stevenson. Outside Williams. That's blocked. Now here comes Nash leading the break. Pull up Jay. Barnes has got 6 in the quarter.
I like the job they're doing. A much better job of getting him involved in the offense here in the second quarter.
Rivers passes to Williams. Alley-oop pass. And so it looks like the Hawks.
Oh, didn't go in.
Moment now to look back to last year's Atlanta Hawks. Fifth in three-point field goal percentage. Fifth in fewest turnovers per game. And they were in the top 10 in assists. A lot of good passers on this team and guys that are willing to make the extra pass as well.
How about the spacing
Williams
that we saw
to make.
From this team last year, Clark? You mentioned the three-point
huge collapse on the defense there.
Field goal percentage from long range. And I think it was a direct result of great unselfish play. And it helps when you can employ that inside-out game. You know, attack a team in the paint and then kick it out for that three-point shot.
Here's Peace. So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact right there.
Well, there's some very popular destinations for free agents around the league. Chicago, New York, Miami. To me, the Lakers are still the premier market for players. You know, big city, a history of winning with the Laker organization, and fantastic weather, of course.
And Steve, to follow up on your point, the whole aspect of Hollywood has always been a big lure for the Lakers as far as recruiting Clark free agents.
We've seen it over the years with all the big names they've gotten to sign in free agency. No doubt about it, the Lakers are still one of those destination teams for a lot of players in the league.
And the Lakers making a change here. Blake's checked in.
Getting wins on the road is always tough for any team in the NBA, even a tough and tested team like the Hawks, and they had to fight for every road win they got last year.
And here is Teague, still looking to get on the scoreboard. Harris. Rebound by Antoine Jameson. Hawks ended up with a road record of 17-16 under Coach Larry Drew, and it seemed like they played well, but just couldn't close out games.
Lakers with ball movement.
In particular, in hostile environments.
It's still, Kevin, I mean, when you look at the numbers, finishing above 500 on the road is good, and that's why the Hawks were a solid playoff team. That's why they gave Boston a lot of trouble in that playoff
series. Harris misses.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
He kicks it to Hill. G covering. Good there, and that would have cut it to single digits. Blake kicks to Jameson over Anderson. Jameson, no luck.
He had to take that 11. Quick shot over him.
Set up.
Johnson outside. He passes to Anderson. Outside Wilkins. There's the pick. Great use of the pick to create room for the jumper. Wilkins has got four this quarter.
You know, he's given them a nice scoring option through most of this game.
Tries for the alley-oop. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Here's Teague. And again, it's
Atlanta on a streak.
There's 10 seconds left here in the second. Blake kicks to Jameson. Over Johnson. Connects on the follow-on jumper. Jameson. And it's 8 points for Jameson.
And he will punish an opponent for giving him that much room from mid-range. He'll hit that all the way.
And that does it for the first half of play. Hawks lead by 13. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
Now, presented by Sprint. All right, I hope you're enjoying this Wednesday of NBA action. Now let's get to the halftime report. For the Atlanta Hawks, they have the lead against the Lakers. A strong beginning to the season, they've wasted no time in getting off on the right foot. Lewis Williams really playing effortlessly. Doesn't matter where he's been on the court, close to the bucket or deep downtown, all the shots are dropping. And for the Lakers, they've been battling. They dialed up the tempo, ripping and running. It's been a fun one to watch. Some great work out there by Jordan Hill. He's got a dozen points and is always looking to go to work on the boards. Let's start things off with a look at what's coming up later tonight. For the Spurs, they'll be up against the Thunder in Oklahoma City. Some stars squaring off in this one. It's always fun to watch. And the other game that's scheduled later tonight, it'll be the Raptors out at Air Canada Center against the Trailblazers. Thanks for being with us. Now back to Los Angeles as the third quarter gets underway.
All right.
Everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters. You look at Kobe Bryant in this game, I mean, he has been everywhere.
Yeah, the points have really come in bunches for him so far. Not really a surprise because you know exactly what he can do.
Well, he's been in the groove all game long, Steve. Not too many hiccups in regards to his shooting, but we also need to take seconds for him, so we're not surprised by it.
Quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor, taking a look at the Lakers.
Close shot.
Out there with Bryant. Then it's Hill. Then there's Rodney Carney. And it's Johnson in at the one spot from 10 feet out.
And that rebound pushes their margin to +5 on the boards. Solid job on the glass.
Well, it's just part of what they've done here to build this big lead. It shouldn't be overlooked. really matter if you've got a ton of speed. You can't finish anything at the rim, but that isn't a problem for Lewis Williams. He can blow by you, but then he can take the contact and finish and get a lot of three-point play opportunities.
Yeah, he's custom-made to provide instant offense too, Steve. I mean, he's fast and can score in a hurry, doesn't need a lot of time, really doesn't need a lot of shots because he can hit you with the three and he can get to the foul line as well.
Kobe, here we go. Over Wilkins. And Kobe gets it to go.
Kobe.
Kobe's got 20.
Boy, what an amazing career Kobe Bryant has had. Last year, he was a close second place in the league in scoring average. Passing
Shaquille. That was a crazy shot right there.
The NBA scoring list.
It was good.
34 years of age, Kobe's got a chance to climb that leaderboard even further before it's all said and done. Well, he's smart. He's getting good shots and he's knocking them down.
I don't know how he made that, but he made that.
Defended by Wilkins. It's a look. Kobe can't hit.
That's a huge part of what they want to do defensively. Limit his easy chances inside.
Well, going back to Kobe, as he's gotten older, you see him working much more in the post and coming off screens. He's still, Clark, putting up great numbers, in his second scoring effect last year. But he's still doing it a little bit differently than he was
years ago. Well, Kevin, he's not going to hang around past his prime, but he's doing everything he can to make adjustments to extend his prime.
Harris against Johnson. Harris dishes to Wilkins. The shot will not go.
That would have been a nice alley-oop there.
Oh, you gotta love the effort, though. Almost showtime.
That's good. Johnson with the shot. Johnson's got his third basket of the night right there.
Well, he's been scoring pretty well on just a few attempts. It might help him out if he was a bit more assertive.
Laker fans coming to life.
Back to Williams.
No, this Atlanta crowd still putting in the sound.
A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Timeout called the Lakers.
All right,
you know what the Lakers is all about?
Good timeout.
They were tested early, though.
Show you which teams led the league in three-point percentage last year. Number 5, the Hawks.
You know, a solid three-point game can be the cornerstone of an effective offense. I mean, it adds a little pop and punch to what a team is doing offensively. Last year, this team was not made up of this good three-point shooting. They had great three-point shooting.
Magic Johnson. They're teaming up.
For the Lakers against Denver. Kobe's illness.
Now the stars are starting to show themselves.
With the suspension, Meta World Peace, you know,
making key shots.
Regular season suspension with the elbow to the side of the head of James Harden. Steve, they were certainly facing their.
Kevin, when they lost to the Oklahoma City Thunder, the younger, more talented team winning in that one. So for the Lakers, you know, moving forward, they've got a lot of talent, but it's aging talent. And sooner or later, they're going to have to get younger on that roster.
Harris picks to Wilkins. Back to Harris. Dishes it to Wilkins. Basket is good. The assist from Harris. Harris has got 3 assists tonight.
You know, this has been his quarter here. Still hasn't missed the mark yet.
Johnson with it. Devin Harris covering. And the basket by Kobe. Kobe's got 6 points in the quarter.
He's a guy that'll take it right into the teeth of the defense. A lot of his points come from inside of 5 feet.
Williams kicks to Wilkins. Shoots from the baseline. And the Hawks getting another basket right there. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Kobe gets a screen from Johnson. Kobe dishes to Bryant. Takes the alley-oop pass. Hill, no good. The Hawks leading by 12. Here's Harris. Looking for his first bucket of the game. And it's the Lakers on the break. Check in for the Lakers. He comes in for Rodney Carter. And comes in for Ivan Johnson. And it's Rivers in for Devin Harris. Johnson. He's got eight. Gay. He's guarded by Williams. And that one's good.
They make a good decision putting him in.
Defense has to prevent the ball from getting down into that area if they're going to be successful, guys.
Here's Rivers. And the shot is good. And the Hawks lead by 12.
I can tell you for sure they didn't want this. I actually can guarantee it. They're getting pounded, brutalized inside. And it wouldn't be so bad if they were getting the same looks on the other end, but that's just not the case.
That is good. And that's now 10 points for Jameson. The Hawks leading by 10. Now Rivers. He has six. Back door. Kicks it to Wilkins. And the Hawks getting another basket right there. The Lakers have gotten 8 of their 11 shots to drop since the break. A great third quarter for them offensively. Outside, Jameson. It's back to Hill. Horford with the block. The Lakers is in the some changes here for the Lakers. Meta World Peace, he's checked in for Hill. Blake comes in for Kobe. And it's Nash in for Magic Johnson. Atlanta also making some changes here. Bellinelli, he's checked in for Wilkins. Rivers comes in for Lou Williams. And it's Teague in for Dr. Eaton. And that one's good.
Kevin, that's exactly the kind of shot you want off the inbounds play.
Rivers passes to Teague. Goes for the alley-oop. And then Rivers in for the dunk.
Now that's how you execute an alley-oop there, fellas.
And with an exclamation point, too, on the finish, throwing it down hard. What a terrific play on both
and
ends.
And they are turned
Lakers
up.
Trail by 12.
They're going for their victory.
By Teague. Nash kicks to Jameson. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give them two chances at the free throw line here.
Anton Jameson, one of the most versatile scoring forwards in a number of ways. One-range shot, but it's that unique array of flip shots and floaters around the basket that sets him apart.
Have you ever had shoes without shoestrings? What's that, yay? Maybe these heels. Is that a made rock? Maybe these wheels. And have a refill. You're feeling like you're running, huh? Now you know how we feel.
And you know, guys, going back to Jameson, they say as a child his dad accidentally set up the rim at 11 feet, and that may have something to do with his soft touch on those in-between shots. He's really got a unique talent for being able to finish a variety of ways over bigger defenders from anywhere from right at the rim all the way out to 17 or 18 feet.
And the second free throw, good.
And there were a lot of questions about how the Hawks would hold up when Al Horford was hurt early last season. And I'll tell you what, they weathered the storm pretty well. And they remained a solid team in that tough Eastern Conference.
Peaks inside the three-point line.
Here they go.
Picking up the assists. Nash has got six assists in the game.
One of those, I can't hear you.
Back to Johnson. Antoine Jameson. Jameson's got 5 rebounds tonight. Some could argue that Horford was one of the most important players on that team. And to be able to not miss a beat without him had to boost, I would think, the confidence of the entire team.
I agree with you, Kevin. And Horford did come back in the playoffs briefly to help. But really, it points out the depth that Atlanta had to be able to have a good season without Horford being a big part of it until late in the year with the playoffs. So I think the depth of this team is one of its strengths.
Blocked.
Wow.
In for Matt Barnes. And then for Atlanta, Al Horford has checked in for Ivan Johnson. And it's Wilkins in for Baron Davis. Off the inbound pass. On ice. Nash has got seven.
I tell you what, right now that mid-range jumper serving them well.
Yes, it is, guys. That's 6 of their last 10 points coming from that mid-range area.
I got it!
Now the pass to Horford. And now the feed to Stevenson. Back to Horford. He feeds it to Stevenson. Shoots the three. They grab their own miss. Right side Teague. He dishes it to Anderson. Hooked away. Stolen by Jameson. Meets inside the three-point line. A three from Day. Rebounded by the Hawks. Horford's got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort.
And are they ever working inside? Good job on the glass.
Excellent job on the glass, Steve. I agree. I mean, they're battling in there. They're fighting, they're scrapping, they're clawing, and they're getting the job done.
Teague can't hit. Lakers trail by 7. They really want a five-head igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
I got to get going.
Oh, Dennis.
King. Dropped into the number 2. He's got 8.
And you can see the strategy has been to take the ball inside.
That's where you get high percentage looks and draw fouls. It's a good way to play.
Hey, comes over with a double team. Here's Wilkins. And again, unable to change momentum here. Clark, one thing we've seen from these guys is excellent ball movement.
And you love to see that, Kevin. I mean, I love watching unselfish play, and I know Steve enjoys that too.
Yeah, that's the best part of the game. I mean, a five-man team game where the ball moves has so much unselfish play. It's beautiful to watch.
Marvel kicks the team. With the dish to Stevenson. Feeds it to Anderson with the lead pass. And that one's good.
He battles his way through.
Stevenson's got his second basket of the night.
Well, every once in a while, they show us some pretty good moves around the hoop.
Nash dishes to Meeks. All good from outside.
He's laboring out there right now, guys. The shot has not been falling for him this quarter.
T kicks to Horford. Puts up the baby hook. Rebounded by the Lakers. Nash has got 3 rebounds now in this one. Pass to Jameson. Gay outside and stolen by Horford. Outside T. Hobbs the alley-oop pass. Wilkins back to T. Passes it to Horford. Feet out and he hits it. Horford's got 13 points.
What a great possession, guys. Got a really good look there.
Nash kicks to Meeks. He kicks to Jameson. Working on Anderson. Out to Nash. Over T. And there's Nash. By Jameson. And it's 9 points for Nash. T kicks to Stevenson.
Close game.
He passes to Wilkins.
Down by 7.
Right side Wilkins. Over Gay. Gay with the block. Tries again. And Wilkins gets it to go on the assist by Horford. He's got 18.
Well, they're now plus 5 in the rebound category, really controlling the glass.
And rebounding is one of those non-glamour stats. I mean, it takes work and effort and tenacity and physicality. But when you look at the scoreboard, you can see the correlation.
Hey, with it, Wilkins picks him up. Jameson left side. Nash dishes it to Gay. Oh, that's blocked. T kicks to Stevenson. And that comes off the assist by Jeff T. And it's an 11-point Hawks lead.
The defense left him just a little window to get through, and he just ducked in for the layup. Terrific job.
Kicks it to Gay. Outside, Jameson. The pass to Nash. Rebounded by the Hawks. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Horford sets a screen for T. And there's the feed to Anderson. He feeds it to Stevenson. He dishes it to T. Feeds it to Stevenson. Wilkins with a screen on Gay. With 1 on the clock. Got it off in time. That's no good. And here at the end of your Lakers double-digit ball game. The Hawks on top, 111. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get started for the fourth quarter. This Friday, Marcin Gortat and the Phoenix Suns take on Derrick Rose and the Chicago Bulls. Live from United Center, Hoops Action.
It's going to be pretty interesting. We're going to see how the Bulls. Well, intro. Whenever their game comes up.
Thanks, Kevin. And it's the Hawks with the Uncontainable Game Award for the offensive stretch they put together. They have been in their grills and bothering shots all game, and they've been able to maintain that level of intensity.
Thank you. And what a concerted effort they put together tonight.
And, you know, that was really the uncontainable aspect in this game, Kevin. They got on the same page as a team and pretty much did what they wanted for the entire stretch.
Well, clearly it's a different game without that scoring run. That was a game-changing run, no doubt.
Fourth quarter on the court for the Hawks. We've got Lewis Williams. Ivan Johnson is out there with Bellinelli. And it's Rivers. And it's Horford at the five down low. It's Williams. Patrick with a jump from the elbow.
Excellent shooting tonight on the board for both teams.
The Hawks. Kobe passes to Barnes. Here's the dish to Johnson. Pass to Kobe. And good coming off the assist by Magic Johnson. Johnson's got his third assist on the night. The Hawks leading by 11. Now here's Williams. Williams gets a screen from Horford. Off the screen. We get the whistle.
You know, one thing I like about Lou Williams, shooting guards game, point guard's body. He's surrounded by bigger guards who are more than capable of handling the ball and defending. So Lou Williams can really fit in nicely with that role.
And let's go back to Lou Williams just for a minute. You know, he comes off the bench, Steve, as you know, you allow him to focus on scoring. When he comes off the bench, he's thinking about one thing, putting the ball in the basket. And you can build your second unit around his ability to score the basketball.
Jordan Hill, he's checked in for the Lakers. Bryant comes in for Matt Barnes. And he can't hit the second.
One of the things Atlanta really wanted to add last season under Larry Drew was a more up-tempo look. And you can see why when you look at their roster. They've got some very athletic players, especially in the starting lineup.
Austin Rivers. I don't know if that was a three-pointer or a two.
Kobe kicks to Johnson. Back to Kobe. Over Williams. Kobe misses. So many guys, as you said, Steve, who have a blend of size and speed and incredible athleticism. It just made sense, I think, for them and, you know, Coach Larry Drew Clark to get him up and down the floor, run him baseline to baseline, get a speed game going.
Well, Kevin, it's easy when you have players like they do to play an up-tempo game. I mean, that's a good fit for that team, a good style for that team. I look at Atlanta, and every player can not only get up and down, but can finish at the rim through contact. They're an excellent team in transition, and that's playing to their strengths when they can play in the open.
Passes it to Johnson in low to Hill. He kicks it to Cornier. It's back to Hill. Gets it to go.
Exactly what they had in mind on that possession.
Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. Williams against Kobe. Harris kicks to Johnson. Good look. Rebound Hill. Hill's got 8 rebounds in this game. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
You're good, Kevin. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
Here's Kobe.
Al Horford with the rebound.
That's a look that he'll never pass up, the one he'll usually never miss.
Williams up on top. He's guarded by Johnson.
It's going to be pretty interesting because that was one of those points that could have helped from the deficit.
Hill against Horford. Back to Williams. Johnson. Johnson sends the screen for Harris. Outside Williams. Kicks to Rivers. Horford the pass to Harris. To the inside. Johnson outside. He passes it to Hill. Back to Johnson. Throws up the alley-oop. And Hill.
What a play. No regular dunk there. A superb alley-oop.
And it was a great pass, too, to set him up.
No, those two have such a great feel for each other. They're just fun to watch play together.
Atlanta calls timeout.
Chance to hear what Larry Drew said to his team. He wants to make sure they stay assertive and aggressive on the offensive end, saying, I don't want to sit on this lead. Let's build on it and not give them a chance of coming back. Guys?
All right, Doris, thank you very much. Dominique Wilkins, she's checked in for Atlanta. Johnson kicks to Wilkins. With nobody on him, he carries the jumper. Wilkins has got 20 points.
Big lead on the boards. Usually there's a big lead in the game. This team is on cruise control.
Well, the rebounding differential is double digits already, so this is a team that just looks bigger and tougher than the opponent.
Gets it to go.
You know, they're getting whatever they want. I mean, 8 straight points coming inside.
The Hawks leading by 12. Williams kicks to Rivers. A fadeaway. A kick out to Williams. There's the triple. Rebound the Lakers. Bryant's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
It's been a tale of 2 halves. Our guys, he was on fire from long range in the first half, but not so much here in the second.
Number 3, Kobe.
He's really struggling in this quarter right now. They need to think about getting the ball out of his hand.
I see him.
Johnson inside. Defended by Bryant. Lakers trail by 14. Johnson with it. Outside, Kobe. And good, coming off. That's 28 points for Kobe Bryant.
It's a good thing he showed up today, because without him, this team would be in big trouble.
Rivers dishes to Williams. Rivers. Over Nash. Rivers can't get it to go.
Even though he missed it, he couldn't pass up that chance.
Yeah, that's an easy jump shot. You gotta take that.
Over Williams. And there's Kobe. It's good on the assist by Johnson. Johnson's got 6 assists here tonight. Johnson against Williams. Rivers. Over Nash. The jumper from the free throw line is good. 8 points for Austin Rivers.
Well, they've done a lot of their damage from mid-range here, guys. I mean, knocking down those shots with regularity.
Now, how about 8 of the last 10 points, guys, coming in mid-range area jump shots? So, shows you don't have to be at the rim to score.
The Hawks leading by 10. It's Wilkins on the wing. And he slams it in one-handed.
He's definitely showing some real sweet dunking skills here.
Are you kidding me? Oh, my gosh. What a play.
Yeah, that was spectacular.
They're taking it to each other. It's this thing of pride, I guess.
10 points in just the second half.
In a good way.
Hawks have gone 7-13 from the field here in the fourth. Back to Williams. Williams with a screen on Johnson. Williams with the ball, and it's Johnson picking him up. And Wilkins gets it to go.
He's been a big part of his team building this lead. Another solid offensive effort.
Johnson kicks to Nash. And the pass to Kobe. There it is. It's handled. Nash has got his 8th assist here tonight.
He may single-handedly bring his team back, guys. What a fantastic quarter he's had.
Williams kicks to Rivers. Wilkins with a screen on Nash. Gets Wilkins on the wing. A feed to Horford. Bryant with the rebound. Bryant's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Here we go. And he trims the single digits. Kobe's got 12 points now in the quarter.
You gotta love what he's doing out there, guys. With his team down, he's personally trying to bring them back.
He feeds it to Rivers.
1 hour.
Wilkins with a screen on Nash. Rivers passes to Wilkins.
Into the recording.
The jump shot. Wilkins has got 14 points here in the second half.
And defensively, remember, you got to fight through screens to avoid giving up open looks.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Steve. And the defense has to go over the top of that screen. That's how they get it done. He can be dangerous from outside. Sure, he didn't get one to go in the first, but we know he can get on the roll and knock him down.
Shoots from the elbow, and he knocks down the jumper.
And there are focus tonight. Talk about some closers.
He's got the guys on the bench going crazy. Rally towels and all.
Kobe, defended by Wilkins. Nash against Rivers. Nash dishes to Kobe. Good, and the assist comes in. And that's now 38 points for Kobe Bryant.
And the shootout continues.
Trading buckets both ways. I mean, offense definitely the focal point for these teams.
Williams kicks to Wilkins. Back to Williams. Another shot. Johnson can't hit. Lakers trail by 7.
Push it, push it.
Now here comes Nash, leading the break. Spins to the middle.
Oh, close from both teams.
Required when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were right in his face.
Rivers kicks to Williams. That's good from Horford on the assist by Williams. Williams has got 5 assists in the game. The Lakers shooting around 60% of the night. Amazing work offensively so far. Timeout called, the Lakers. You have to like what we're seeing from Lou Williams.
He's on fire. They needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
Here's Hill from the inbound.
So far, going for more of an inside game here in the second half, and I like that. A little smash mouth basketball, taking it inside.
They aren't giving up.
Williams. Back to Wilkins. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Williams. Williams has got 6 assists now in the game. Lakers trail by 9. Nash left side. Back to Kobe. For Wilkins. And there's Kobe. Good on the assist by Nash. Kobe's got 40 points. There's 1:26 left in the fourth. He dishes it to Williams. Wilkins with a screen on Johnson. Right side Wilkins. Over Hill. Rebounded by the Lakers.
Man, it's going to be tough here, Clark.
You know, I agree with you, Steve. I mean, they need some big plays to steal this.
And 101 left in the game. Harris up top, defended by Nash. Harris dishes to Wilkins. Over Bryant. Dominique Wilkins again. Wilkins has got 32 points in the game.
He's been absolutely phenomenal here in this close game. I mean, making all but one of his 8 shots down the stretch. That's huge.
Kobe.
And for the Hawks, they're shooting 57% in this fourth quarter. Nash against Harris. Leads him in there. Wilkins kicks to Harris. Back to Wilkins. Down low. The kick out to Williams. The kick out to Wilkins. Wilkins draws the double. Johnson, he's guarded by Hill. And the basket by Johnson. And the Hawks lead by 6.
They really executed well here offensively.
Well, that's going to take a major catastrophe, a colossal collapse, for them to not walk away with the win.
And the Lakers call time here. They're trailing by 6. 7 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
Well, there's a little bit of time here to play with, so a 3 and a quick foul could make things interesting.
Very much so. Either way you cut it, they're going to need a pair of 3s and some help at the other end as well.
7 seconds left in the fourth quarter. They get the rebound. Here's Hill. Offline. And so the Hawks get the win. Was a solid win.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
Well, that'll do it. For Doris Burke, Steve Curry, Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin.
That is the game. The Hawks starting strong this season so far.
Jordan, player of the game, Dominique Wilkins.
It's crazy because he has 32 points. Atlanta scored 132 points, which means they scored 100 without him. That's pretty decent. I'm going to check out box score. Tonight, they played for the Lakers and probably would have been the player of the game. Kobe Bryant, Jordan Hill for the Lakers team, Magic Johnson, Antoine Jamison, Steve Nash, Rudy Gay, Matt Barnes, Steve Blake, Jody Meeks, Rodney Carney, Joe Bryant, Meta World Peace, for Atlanta, we have our Jordan player of the gamer, Dominic Wilkins. Luis Williams. He had 30 points, which is nice. Al Horford. Marco Bellinelli. Yvonne Johnson. Baron Davis. Austin Rivers. Sean Stevenson. Doc Rivers. Chris Anderson. Jeff Teague. Devin Harris. Right, here's the team stats. For Atlanta Hawks, Los Angeles Lakers. All right, if you like this, please subscribe.